Yo, what is going on, everyone? Chris here with the long-awaited Blu-ray release of one of the fun teenage comedies of the 80s, Pretty in Pink, starring Molly Ringwald, Harry Dean Stanton, James Spader, and Jon Cryer, best known for playing Alan Harper, Charlie's freeloading brother on Two and a Half Men.
Oh, I guess I'll have to find a babysitter for Jake.
I don't need a babysitter. Nothing's gonna happen to me.
I'm worried about you. I'm worried about my house.
It's 2450.
Whoa. Okay. Oh, jeez.
What?
I walked out of the house without my wallet. Can you believe it?
Strangely enough, I can.
Love that show. So anyway, Pretty in Pink has been fully restored from the 4K transfer, which was supervised by director Howard Deutch. And it's now part of the Paramount Presents line with Spy Number 6. And I love these Paramount Presents releases because not only are they newly remastered, you also get brand new bonus material as well as the original poster art inside the flap of the slipcover. And this movie was the missing link from the John Hughes movies in which he wrote, but didn't get the Blu-ray treatment up until now. So in regards to the presentation, this movie was shot on 35mm film, and I'm pleased to inform that it maintains the film-like feel, with the grain intact, and the colors look great, not overly saturated, and black lows are deep to the right degree, and skin tones are natural. This is a very nice transfer, although some softness occurs, which you'll notice in a few scenes on faces, but for the majority of the film, it's quite sharp, especially on hair and clothing and surrounding objects, either inside the house or exterior shots. I think fans of the film will be very pleased with this transfer. For the audio, this features the DTS 5.1, and it's a solid track that works well with the story. I found the dialogue crisp and clear. So with all that being said, I'm rating both the picture and audio quality a 4.5 out of a 5. Definitely a must-own. Paramount did a great job with this release. And I'm going to show you guys a few screenshots I took from the Blu-ray disc itself, but don't judge it based on these images alone. This is just to give you guys an idea of how it looks. And as far as bonus material, you get a brand new filmmaker-focused interview with the director of the film. And that has a runtime of nearly 8 minutes, plus the isolated score track is included, as well as the original ending called The Lost Dance, and a theatrical trailer. So there you have it, guys, the long-awaited release of one of the greatest films of the 1980s. And as always, thanks for taking a look. Subscribe to my channel if you're new here, and I'll see you all in the next one. Take care.